Now we are discussing about a topic called kinematics in physics. In kinematics, we are now discussing about the rest and motion. It is nothing but discussing about the position of an object with time. If the object is changing its position with time, then we keep saying that the body is under motion. If the position of the body is not changing with time, we say that it is at rest. And one more thing, it's a relative quantity also. For example, we are in a particular position, we are not moving. We are not moving, we are sitting or standing, we are not moving. We are at rest. With respect to an object beside us, we are not moving. But with respect to sun, we are moving. With respect to moon, we are moving. So in this case, the rest and motion are relative quantities. It depends on with what you are comparing with. If you are comparing yourself with the heavenly bodies, though you are sitting, you are under motion. If you compare yourself with your neighboring body, with your adjacent body which is under rest, so relatively the distance is not changing, your position is fixed with respect to that object. So rest and motion are relative quantities. They are not fixed. They are relative. That depends on with what you are comparing with. So now in this discussion about kinematics, now we are going to discuss about the next thing, that is distance and displacement. What is the meaning of distance? And what is the meaning of displacement? In this particular case, my dear friends, distance is, for example, you are moving from one point A to another point B, and you are following a path like this, you are following a road like this, you are going in a road, the road is like that. So this is the actual path in which you are going. So that is called the distance between point A and point B. So the distance between two points is nothing but the actual path in which you are moving from A to B. We call that path as distance. And displacement means the shortest path between A and B. If you draw, the shortest line is the straight line, which joins A to B. So that is called the shortest distance between A and B, we call it as a displacement. So now we have been discussing about distance and displacement. Distance is nothing but the actual path covered by the body. Distance is nothing but the actual path covered by the body. Generally we may represent it by some other letter. And distance is a scalar quantity. What is the meaning of a scalar quantity? Scalar quantity means it has only magnitude, but there is no direction. Such kind of quantity we call it as a scalar quantity. For example, 5 meters is distance. 5 meters in the direction of north or in the direction of east, that is displacement. In the case of displacement, for our convenience, you can represent it with any argument. Let it be from D or S or anything. Here, displacement is a vector quantity. What's the meaning of a vector quantity? Vector quantity is a physical quantity which has magnitude as well as direction. It is even having direction. Such quantity is called a vector quantity. So, displacement is a vector quantity. We have to give the direction in which you are moving. In the case of distance, you need not talk about the direction. So, now you understood what is the meaning of distance and displacement. Distance and displacement, both of them are measured in CGS system in centimeter. Both of them are measured in centimeters. CGS system. In MKS system, it is being measured in meters. some more examples of distance and displacement, some more problems. Let us have a discussion about something more. Now we have discussed what is rest and what is motion. Rest and motion means if a position of the body is not changing with time, we say that it has rest. But rest and motion are relative quantities with what you are comparing with. That is very important. And you have seen what is a scalar quantity and what is a vector quantity. Scalar quantities are those quantities whose magnitude is given, but there is no need of direction. The physical quantity which has only magnitude but no direction is called the scalar quantity. Which has magnitude as well as direction is called a vector quantity. And distance and displacement, just now we have seen, when you are taking two bodies, the actual path covered by the body is called the distance, and the shortest distance between A and B is called the displacement. Now let us see in the next session, let us see some more applications of distance and displacement. Thank you.